Hello, Dark Souls fans. I've got some bad, and well, welcome back to Dark Souls, horribly in Dark Souls 3. I'm your host, ShadowFury333, with a bit of bad news. Gray Rat died. Yep, right here. I already got the ash, but yeah, Gray Rat died. Left an ash, which I'll bring back, so we have that at least. Gray Rat's ashes. Umble ash of Gray Rat of the Undead Settlement. With this, the Shrine Handmaid will prepare new items. Gray Rat was a thief who fancied himself a martyr for the poor, which is what drove him to climb the wall. Not sure which wall they're talking about. I mean, I actually found this the other day. I also found another ash, which I'll go over in a sec. Right in here. Kind of surprised I missed it, actually, just on this random corpse. Not a named corpse, but still. Excrement-covered ashes. Unclean umbral ash coated with excrement. Perhaps it's possible the handmaid of Firelink Shrine could turn this into a few new things. Oh, to savor the sweet pungency, but what more? I don't know if that's supposed to be her saying that or what, but I don't know. I don't know who to be saying, so I don't know how to voice that. But yeah, my guess is that Gray Rat tried to climb here or something. Somewhere along this area, and either I was supposed to have dropped a ladder down so they could do it, because I'm pretty sure they don't have to die, but I guess they must have climbed up a wall, fallen down, gotten knocked out, then gotten torn to shreds, like floated into the sewer. But I don't know. I feel like I missed something. I feel like there was something I was supposed to do, some shortcut I was supposed to open, or something I was supposed to hit or change or tweak. I mean, if I go, I mean, up there, that's where you go through this area. You go through this area, you come up. There's the area with the Estus soup, which is right up the staircase. Maybe up here you're supposed to go and do something. Maybe that's how it was supposed to work. And I totally missed it. I don't know. Yeah, here's the Estus soup. And everything else just goes kind of out of the way, so I don't really know if I was supposed to do anything here. Or what. But yeah, so that kind of sucks. But we have the ashes, so presumably the ashes will get us Gray Rat stuff from whatever they found before they went off to, well, be dead. So I'll just get back to Firelink Shrine and then figure out what Gray Rat found, I guess. And I'm hoping that Gray Rat found Elite Knight armor before dying, and then I'll at least be able to get that. Because I have been waiting for that, and I have not found it. And Henri had it, but well, I'll start with the shit
gracious
one.
Gracious, passing fine ash thou'st given. Let this ash bestow nourishment. I only hope these new wares content thee.
I'm curious what this one is. Well, dung pie, that's not surprising. Always material marked by a long plant stalk that was not properly digested. Throw behind at enemies to inflict toxin buildup. Strictly speaking, this consists of different material than the dung pie, but waste is waste. No sense in splitting hairs. Yeah, not much else changed for armor. Oh yeah, this is Lautrec's armor I was talking about before when I accidentally was saying the brass armor. No, it's the embraced armor. The Pitium Bull Embraced Knight is Lautrec. To fix the depiction of Goddess Fina, the face is crafted to depict the goddess's embrace, just quite ignoring the fact that her love is in fact as fickle as the weather. Adrift, or the helmet, adrift on a sea of isolation, only his faith in the love of his goddess remained true, and so the knight forsook all else. But yeah, I guess that's it. So, not Elite Knight armor. Oh, hey. It's dancer stuff. Okay, well, At any rate, I'm gonna be really more concerned
gracious
about Greyrat's ashes.
And on. Oh, yes. Forgive an old woman's idle prate. I'm sure an ashen one such as thee would never indulge such base contrivances.
Okay, that's Greyrat stuff, yeah. Oh wow, Zweihänder, Lothric Knight Greatsword. Knight's Crossbow. Oh, interesting. So it has lightning damage. A little curious about that, actually. I'll check this out between cuts at some point. Hard Leather Knight. Elite Knight! Yeah! Greyrat's passing was not in vain, although admittedly I'd rather that Greyrat had lived so that I could get this directly, but whatever. Passing's not in vain, that's the important part. Oh, is this lighter than... Oh, interesting! That's new. Historically speaking, the Elite Knight armor has been heavier than the Knight armor, but slightly better. In this game, it's slightly lighter. It looks like it's a bit more weight efficient, but slightly lighter, but not quite as effective. Okay, well that's, like I said, really unfortunate, actually. I'd rather that Greyrat were not dead, but at least, like I said, the passing was not in vain. Oh, not something I need a lot of. Wood grain ring. This special ring crafted in an eastern land is made of metal, but with a wood grain crest on its surface. Slows equipment degradation. Wielders of swords originating in the same region follow a practice of inscribing special words on the blades of their swords and are naturally drawn to this ring. Okay, well... Oh! Lightning bolt! The new bolt. Bolts imbued with the lightning created by the giant blacksmith of the gods. However, the gods never used crossbows. These bolts are likely artifacts of the dragonless era when the pact between gods and humans was upheld. Alright, I'm curious if I want to get those. I kind of do... Huh. Like I said, I'll play around with that later. The main thing was that I'm finally going to be able to get, at least I think finally, I guess, going to be able to have the... Yeah, this is about right, yeah. That's what I wanted. Kind of wish the lower skirt was more, like the skirt was bluer. It's not quite what I'm looking for. I mean, that's bluer, but I overall prefer the design of the skirt I was wearing before. Or was it? Maiden skirt, yeah. Hmm. Well, at any rate, that's that. So I'm gonna just mess around with some stuff, and then I'll be back to Lothric Castle to continue adventuring! There's a reference there. I'll leave it to the viewers to figure it out. Although I actually do quite like the setup. I am gonna keep using the Wolf Knight Greatsword, obviously, but I like how this looks a lot. I didn't realize Pontiff Knight Armor was actually much closer to what I was looking for than Elite Knight Armor was. So yeah, I'm gonna go with this. And I'll probably put the hat back on at some point once I realize just how bad it is to not have a hat. But, eh, let's go a little while without it. And if you get that reference, then you'll know one of the inspirations for the character. Pretty small inspiration, actually. Mostly the aesthetic inspiration. Honestly, most of the inspiration for this character is the fact that I really, really, really want to play Bloodborne, and I don't have a PS4, and I can't really fit a PS4 in my place, so I don't think I'll ever be able to play the game. Thus the crossbow. Oh, wait. I never tried that knight crossbow. Eh, whatever. Anyway, that's just lightning damage. I doubt it's something like staggers enemies when you hit them as a counter hit. Like, if that was a thing, that would be awesome, but I don't think that's a thing. I seriously doubt that. Anyway, we're back in Lothric Castle, and I don't see anything else here that's particularly... Oh, wait, there's this. Aw, they're missing their friend. I recommend joining them. Join your friend in death! Or not? Ow. Maybe I shouldn't. Ah! Thinking I might want to stick to the longsword for now. I still need more, far more of those Titanite skills. It's just, it's a DPS question. Like, especially since my style seems to be more attack while they're stunned until they just die. That's a lot easier to do with this weapon, and it's also a lot more damaging at this point with the longsword. One more upgrade to the Wolf Knight Greatsword, it'll probably be about even. But for now, it's pretty much the one. Also, that was... Did I get an armor piece there? I can't remember. I didn't notice. I feel kind of bad. I should have noticed if I got something. No, I didn't get anything there. I feel kind of silly. I was so distracted. I distracted myself. But I got Titanite Scale, and I don't think much else... Or, sorry. Large Titanite Shard, and... Yeah. What the heck did I just pick up? Crap. Note to self, pay more attention when picking stuff up. Okay, so it's not a ring. Oh well, it's probably not a big deal. I say that merely to assuage my own guilt. I'm actually really curious about what that was and feel kind of silly I didn't pick it up. It wasn't a soul. Wasn't apparently any special item. Might have been this divine blessing, but I don't think so. Oh well. Moving on. I was wondering if there was going to be a dragon here. I was like, wait a sec, this is a bridge, like one that would have a dragon on it, right? Right. Or, you know, two. Huh. Okay, well, whatever. You're not exactly threatening, you know. Am I doing something wrong here? I mean, I guess I could risk my own life and just rush it. You know, why not? Why not risk my life? I mean, how often is he gonna breathe fire? Ah, fairly often! Ow! Okay, no, that's just a path blocker. There's no way through without tediously shooting that dragon so many times. Ow. Alright, forget it. Have to take another route. Well, so much for that. Oh wait, this is the same route. How do I get down from there? I guess I just have to drop. I guess that's the idea, is you get on here, and then you drop down here. See you, space dragons. Oh, or I could have gone to the other side and dropped down there. Ah, whatever. I do kind of find it funny. I looked at the bridge and thought, there's going to be dragons here. And I was pretty much rolling out of the way as I... Oh, another goo zombie. Ow. Oh, crap. Yeah. Huh. You know what'd be really nice? Not lightning bolts, but fire bolts. For stuff like this, because this thing is super weak to fire. Ow. Got some of these for you. Oh, shoot. How do I get out? Oh, I do that. Well, I've got more. You want this? Ow. Well, okay, apparently yes, but now you're good. Oh man, I'm glad I learned that in the Wild All Authoric. More Titanite chunks, large Titanite shards. Titanite scales would be a favorite. If you have one of those Titanite lizards, I'd love to fight them and get some Titanite scales. I mean, I'd love to fight them, and I'd love to get Titanite scales. The two are independent. I enjoy doing both. More twinkling. Wow, lots of Titanite in this little gutter. The moat, a Titanite moat. That's what this is. Actually, it's a ditch, not a moat. No, it's probably usually a moat. Although, on the other hand, there is this path up here, which would be kind of inconvenient when flooded. Hey! I got my wish! Oh, wait, never mind. I didn't get my wish. That lizard can live for... well... thanks for the warning. Are those poisonous? I don't want to know. Nope, they are not. They are not poisonous. We're good. Okay. Well, that was very interesting and adventurous. I'm curious to see what'll happen next. A knife in my arm. Oh, wait, why did I roll away from you? I was in a perfect position to slash you. That did not deter me later on from slashing you. Learn to whoa. Yeah, no, I'll stick with my original statement. Learn to fight! Okay, I take back everything I said about Dark Souls 3's backstab system. It just saved my life. I don't know if you noticed, but that monster was trying to that enemy was trying to backstab me and failed to... would you stop? Yeah, that was a backstab attempt right there, and that failed because the backstab system of this game works the way it does, where if you're just out, you might try to backstab and it's not gonna work. And I just happened to be out of the way in the right position, and I think I rolled at the right time too, that I didn't get hit. Okay, there's the bonfires at before. I kind of like the design of this level. Oh, another winged knight. Who's there? It's me. Ah, I thought I'd backstab you. Good thing I didn't stop too soon. There we go, got my backstab. Note, I am wearing both Aldrich rings, so I really do like backstabs a lot. Oh wait, you've seen this probably more recently than I have. Come to think of it, it's like, wait a sec, you... oh, seriously? Not sure what good that did you, but okay. Oh, a sniper crossbow. Pretty sure sniper crossbow is pretty much just distance, though. I want to know what's like, though. Let's try it. So give it a go. Oh, wow. Okay, no, it's just way slower. It's probably really good when you're Oh, no, it doesn't do that. I was assuming you could scroll wheel and it would zoom in. Well, okay, obviously needs upgrading. But I don't plan to use it. Pure crossbow build, I could totally see doing that. But my build is sidearm crossbow. So, sadly, not the most applicable. Still kind of cool, though. Neat to have. Have not got the vitality, and I probably won't on this character. I mean, I am kind of building up this character to be still in the 90 to 120 range, which is the standard PvP range. And that's basically meaning that the way I have my build set up so far, Every point of vitality is one less point of vigor or attunement. And I don't need vitality that bad. Vigor and attunement, on the other hand, I really do want. I mean, you can never have too much health, even though I keep trying to act like you can. And you... I guess you can have too much magic, but at the same time, it would be nice to have a bit more magic slots, more attunement slots, more FP. It'd be handy. I realize I'm not using Lightning Spear much, and I probably wouldn't use Wrath of the Gods much either. But you never know. Maybe I would. Maybe it'd be a useful thing. Now, is there a way to this other side without totally foolishly risking my life? It looks like no. I'm going to have to totally and foolishly risk my life. I'm not missing anything, am I? No. Well, this whole area looks like simply a path to a sniper crossbow. Is that really it? That can't just be it. Unless I'm supposed to drop down. No, this is where I came in. This is actually, that was the guy who was throwing all those Lloyd's talismans at me and being really annoying in the last episode. That guy just killed up Kolo. So I guess this is just to disarm that area briefly, and that's about it. Huh. Well, maybe there's something over here. Nope. Oops. That's what I wanted to use. Okay, if you enjoy being backstabbed that much, I'm very willing to oblige. Ow. Well, it doesn't really matter. I'm right next to the bonfire, and obviously I'm gonna go to it, so there's no actually, maybe I won't. Good question, will I? Yeah. Six Estus. Or actually, before I do... Another question. Oh, right, this is the other side. So, yeah. Bonfire. Might as well. Got a nice little tour of the area, though. I mean, they'll certainly need... Oh, wait, shoot, there's the goo zombies at the bottom. I'm gonna have to deal with those again. I just remembered I didn't deal with them. Undead Bone Shard? That was totally worth it. Wait. Those goo zombies were respawning as usual, right? I'm guessing. Oh, what's this? Yes, could be a dead end. Could most certainly be a dead end. Why is this here? Why is this not guarded? There's something going on here. I don't understand. Okay, well, I'm not liking this one bit. My thought was maybe you could jump between them, but I don't think there's enough space, so no, I don't understand. This is a really conspicuous railing, and I don't see much purpose for it. Now, the ambush... Actually, no, I'm gonna do... Screw all y'all! Except you, I'm gonna kill you before I go goo zombie. Because screw your goo zombie! And then ambushes happen... Where are the... Oh. Where are the ambushers coming from? They're not just suddenly spawning in the sky, are they? Like, they're jumping down from somewhere. There we go. All right, well, you're very dead. And I don't really care. So, what I actually realized, looking down there, is that there's another path on the first place I dropped to, and that's the one I care about. That's the one I wanted to take in the first place. I just ended up dropping further, finding the ambush spot. Not super important. What's super important is that path on the near side. And also dragons. Dragons are fairly important. Ah, seriously, I can't target them from that angle? Nothing behind there. Okay, this is real bullcrap. Ah, seriously? Wow. I was trying to roll to the side, not directly in front of me. What the heck? Not down forward. Right forward. The forward and to the right. I was trying to roll forward and to the right, and it ended up rolling directly forward. Must not hit the in time. All right. Well, clearly I didn't hit the right button in time. Yeah. Oh no, the right direction. The move to the right, the strafe right button. Oh wait. Nope. Alright, well that's not ideal, but okay. Ah! Doesn't stop me from using embers, fool! Who's throwing- oh, it's someone in the tower. Ow. Oh, where did it go? Shoot. Nor does it stop me from Aldrich healing, so Aldrich healing away! Ah, that's annoying. Oh wait, this is... This is annoying. It's annoying in a way that I can respect, but it's still annoying. I actually really appreciate this design because... Oh, that's where it is. Because, I mean, it's one of those things where in this game you get, especially in 3, because you get so much Estus, it's kind of neat that you have an enemy that's basically entirely there to screw up your Estus. Like, make you stop taking Estus for granted. Because really, I've got 12 Estus flasks, and I probably have missed Estus shards. I'm guessing. Because I'm sure there's at least one optional area I've missed entirely. I know there's one space that I probably need a meditate gesture, like probably some magical painted world type thing that I need to use the meditate gesture or some kind of meditation gesture in order to get from the Irithyll dungeon shortcut. And then there might be others that I don't even know about, haven't even gotten even the faintest hint about. And I have 12 Estus, well, 13 actually. And my Estus flask is, what, plus 7? Yeah, so it heals up most of my health so far. It probably heals up about 600 or 700 health. So I only need one charge of Estus for every time I take like 2 or 3 hits. Someone throwing Lloyd's or Undead Hunter Charms on me, that's gonna make me actually think again and feel tense again rather than going, oh well, I got hit, I'll Estus up, I got hit, I'll Estus up, doing it over and over and over and over again. Like, I'm actually forced to think now. Oh, wait, crap. That's fire. So there's 2 dragons here. Both of which are relatively vulnerable, actually. Eat my bolts! I feel like this is a reason why lightning bolts were- Oh, wait a sec. Eat my lightning spears! What, seriously? There we go. Oh, I see. I have to hit the head and it won't let me target the head directly. Ow. Huh. I'm rethinking that knight's crossbow. Like, seriously thinking maybe I should go get one of the knight's crossbows with lightning bolts. At least to deal with this crap. Oh, right. Yeah. I might want to... Okay, you know, I'm just going to leave this thing alone. I'll get a nice crossbow later on and use that to deal with it. Of course, I'm going to have to actually leave it alone. Let it get that out of its system. Whatever chemical cocktail causes that fire, get it out of its system. Then I'll move on. I'll kill it later. Oh, wait. Ow. Ow. Fire's hot. Public service announcement. Fire indeed hot. Ow. Alright, well, I'm gonna have to get one of those knight's crossbows, I think. And then upgrade it. It's probably twinkling. So yeah, oh wait, do I have any souls to crack? Yeah, I got souls to crack. Alright, be back in a sec. Okay, lightning bolts aren't that much better, apparently. It's hard to judge, since this thing won't keep its head still. Alright, so killing this is going to be an exercise in tedium, not one in skill. Well, anyway, I guess I might as well deal with that. One down. Oh, they're both down. Okay. Except it sounds like something really bad happened, so I don't know. Maybe I'll live to regret that? Or, being the case, die to regret that? Or I should say, as is often the case. As is usually the case. Regret is usually preceded by and followed by death. But I guess I opened the path. Oh, I was hoping I'd be able to walk up this thing's neck. Are these permanently gone, or am I gonna have to waste 60 bolts every time I want to get through this area? Like, get across this bridge. I don't know, they seem pretty dead to me. Didn't get any souls for her, though. There must have been a better way of doing that. Don't know what it is, but there must have been, because that was tedious and inefficient. And I didn't get any reward, which means there was something else going on that I missed. I think that noise is just both of those goo zombies. Is there no way to get up to the... There must be a way to get up where the dragon is. I just don't know what it is. Oh, not this again. Okay, I'm gonna look for a shortcut first. Actually, I think I might just end the episode, but okay, another one of those Irithyll night things that we fought a long time ago back in the Undead Settlement. Now there's another one. Alright, how many of you guys are there? Well, there's a ladder over there. And a goo zombie. Oh boy. Doesn't help that I can't see. Hey, thanks for the backstab. That'll help me recover. Alright, that's some of the basic problems dealt with. But there's also the fact that if I were to go up there, I'd have to deal with a goo zombie and what looks like, oh, just a couple normal zombie things. Or I can go up from the top. I guess I should appreciate there's a shortcut. My guess is there's a bonfire around here somewhere, and that's a shortcut to the Please tell me it didn't waken me. Ow! Oh, come on, just let me get a hit in. Shit. That's not an easy area to get to. There's gotta be a shortcut around there. I just can't find it, and I've got to end the episode now because it's been a long time for you for this episode, so gotta call it. A little unsatisfying, but at least I have a much better look now. I really like how this looks. Oh wait, no, I don't want brass. I want the silver knight. There we go. That's how I like how it looks. There we go. So anyway, thank you for watching, and see you in the next one.